Hey, you all, what's going on? Welcome to another episode of Infinite Lock. It's your boy, Erick. Today, we have another SF9 reaction. We have the Scream music video, their newest release, and then we have one of their members, Yoo Taeyang. We have his performance video, the Kiss Kiss. SF9, I mean, I call them Model Academy. You know what I'm saying? Model Academy, Model Unit. I don't know if that's already a nickname for them, but... it looks like their agent. They look like their agency just stalked the nearest runways and just picked, just picking specimens off the runway. Hey, come be an idol, because they have the height, they have they're slim. You know what I'm saying? They have the look, that Model S look across the board, with all of the members, and some of them are actors and do variety stuff and stuff like that. I just got done watching a K-drama starring Rowoon. She Would Never Know, I think. And he did an amazing job. I also watched Tomorrow with him as well. That was my first one that I saw him in, and he ate that role up as well. I think Chami was in Castle. I saw that. I can't remember the title, but I saw that as well. He did a great job acting in that role. Good Guy is one of my favorite song, K-pop songs, definitely one of my favorite boy group songs. I don't know, something about the vibe of that song that I really, really like. All of their music is super unique. I've heard Trauma, I've heard Teardrop. It was a joke that people were telling me that they're one of the most family friendly groups out there. That was a lie. Their stage performance is a kill. You know what I mean? In the best way possible. They really get after it. It's models that can sing and dance. You know what I mean? That's SF9 in a nutshell for me. Let's check out Scream. I'm interested to see what type of vibe. This is going to be something super unique, or if it's going to be more summery. It looks like it's going to be a summery type of video, so we'll see. And then we'll get into Yoo Taeyang's performance video. Before we get into the video, make sure you all like, comment, subscribe, turn your post notifications on. Got a lot of stuff coming your way. And SF9 with Scream. Who's away in the military? I know some members are not here. Come on, Taeyang. Okay, Hui Young. My boy Chami. This is Dawan, right? The last member was Dawan, I believe. Look, that jacket is sick. Hey. I feel like this is a metaphor. Ooh, that jacket is sick. Hold on. Wow. I feel like this is a metaphor for something, but I won't speak on it. Come on, Taeyang with vocals. Chami. I don't see Rowoon. Is Insong missing? My boy got them toes out. These background harmonies. Ooh, that lime green with the baby blue background. Y'all know I love my colors. Hey. I'm convinced this is Kai's younger brother. I'm convinced Yoo Taeyang is Kai's younger brother. I just think at this point, I think Kai, Yoo Taeyang, NCT Taeyong, and AT's son are all one big happy family of very disrespectful brothers and siblings, and they, because the energy level from each one of them is very, very congruent. You know what I mean? They have very similar effects when they get in that middle, that center. I just knew Taeyang was gonna, he has to be the only one with no shirt on. Like, does he eat, like, at this point, I'm starting, like, regular t-shirts, I'm starting to think that certain idols aren't required to own regular t-shirts. And I think Taeyang has just moved on the list of, I've done a rant about Kai with this as well. I think that Taeyang is on that list. They've told, agency has told him, they threw all his shirts out when he arrived at the agency the first day. They threw all of his regular t-shirts out, like everything. The only things he'll wear up top are things with holes in them, rips, the neck all out, chest all out. Those are the only things he's allowed to wear at this point. It's got to be a rule. I would like to see his contract, because I think that is a rule. He's not allowed to wear just a regular t-shirt. I mean, that jacket is so crazy. Okay, footwork. Who is this? I like his vibe. I think. Okay, I like that little mini anti-drop moment. Okay, vocals. Hey. Okay, hey man. You better, hey man. Come on, Taeyang. Hey, 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 hey. Yes, sir. So that was SF9 with Scream. I just saw that was their 11th mini album. Damn, they've been, my bad, I just kicked my camera. Everything cool? Yeah, damn, that was crazy. 11, like, they've been, how long has SF9 been in the game? I can't remember. Like, that's man, a lot of body of work. I mean, they just, again, everything is unique. That gave me, what vibes did that give me? That gave me, it's a group that just Astro dropped Candy Sugar Pop. That was like a more like, I'm just talking about the video itself, the aesthetic of the video, all of like the ice cream and lollipop type stuff. It was kind of similar, but the songs were completely different. Of course, each group has their own distinct style that's nothing like the other. But I just, the aesthetic of it was very reminiscent of that. I feel like groups are definitely taking advantage of that summer concept this year. And I think SF9 put their own spin on it. They definitely had a beautiful cadence, and the chorus is super catchy. I think, again, I've said this before, especially in K-pop, I think they're taking full advantage of the TikTok era of music. And a lot of the songs are built around a catchy chorus, you know what I mean? Easy to follow choreography at points. You know, even if the choreography is difficult, they're going to try to give you, you know, an 8 count of some of just a nice catchy dance step that can be repeated. But again, they have immense talent. I don't know if Rowoon is like filming or if he's away at military service. But I know there were like 3 members I didn't see. For the most part, I knew most of the members that were present, but there are some that I think InSong was there. I know I asked on the video, was InSong gone? I think InSong was there. And I can't remember like two of the other names. So just let me know in the comments who was who. Again, I'm pretty sure I know Dawan, Huiyoung, Chami, Taeyang, and of course Rowoon. And there was another. Nah, I can't remember. Yeah, super talented. Again, model university. You know what I'm saying? They all just look like models. They look super tall. Kind of like Astro almost, you know what I mean? I get the same kind of vibes from Astro, but their music is more like, I don't know. Their music is more tailored to a certain aesthetic, I would say. So yeah, let's get into SF9's Yoo Taeyang with his Kiss Kiss performance video. I'm guessing this is a fake tattoo and this is not real because I don't think I saw that in the last music video. Iconic song. I ain't gonna lie. I'm say this right now. I don't support some of the situations Chris Brown has found himself in throughout the years. However, he is one of the greatest artists of our generation. He's one of the greatest male, pop, R&B, whatever category you want to put him in. He's one of the greatest of all time. I feel like a lot more idols would admit to him being their inspiration, or, you know, them taking a lot of inspiration from him, if he didn't have some of the incidents in the past that he does. A lot more idols would be more willing to admit that they try to emulate Chris Brown, because I'm almost 100% certain that there are way more idols that idolize Chris Brown than would admit, you know what I'm saying, than have said publicly. You know, you have your Baekhyun, you have your GOT7, Yugyeom, you have specific idols that have made that known, but there are a lot more idols that would admit to that, you know, if they, you know, weren't nervous about the backlash or anything like that. So just putting that out there, this is an iconic song. He early on in his career, especially, iconic moments, iconic bops. So, Chris Brown, T-Pain, you heard it here first. Nappy Boy Radio live. That kiss, kiss. Bro. Hold on, the chord control, the balance, the footwork in that whole little section, and that was damn near warm up for him. That was insane. Hey, hey, did he choose this song? Is he a Chris Brown fan? Who are his inspirations as dancers and artists? I want to know. I would guess Usher, Chris Brown. You better give me a slight crump. Tap, 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 tap. Bro, his balance is crazy. Say, let me holler at you. You so ha, 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 ha. You think I'll be hollering if you not, 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 not. I'm king of the town. You should take a look around. Teddy Pender down is in the spot, 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 spot. Ooh, he is killing this, bro. I'm singing the song, but I'm locked in. Taeyang is eating this up. You better give me a shimmy, shimmy, yeah. Hey, hey, hey. Let's say McDonald's. STP and CB, I'm a nappy boy. Ooh, the knees. Come on, Bro, the knees and the ankle control is crazy. Bro, even on that kick out, bro, the balance, the one leg balance right there. Come on, bro. Hey, who? Come on, Chris Brown, I hear you. Haynes, Chris Brown. Whoa, what? Oh my God, this dude is sick. Oh, he's hitting every beat. Oh, that was sick. I need to know who choreographed that. I need to know where his inspiration is. So that was Yoo Taeyang of SF9 with his Kiss Kiss by Chris Brown performance video. That was sickening. I know, you know, I was singing a song, you know, because it's core memory unlocked. This Chris Brown, early Chris Brown, it's iconic. You know what I'm saying? It's iconic music choice selection. But that routine right there was insane. I think he's one of the most underrated. I already thought that. I've said this before in my other SF9 reactions. If you haven't seen it, go check the playlist. He is one of the most underrated main dancers in the industry. But I am convinced he really might be like a top three most underrated main dancer. Like, it's definitely in the male category. He is insane. He ate. That was crazy. So I had to rewind so many parts because I'm like, there's no way he just did that. There was no low in the choreo. This wasn't anything chill. He went 100% all out, 120% all out. The lip ring, the way he's staring at the camera, he just has that, like I said, that Kai of EXO. He's cut from that cloth. You can tell, like, that performance aspect is just... It runs deep there. I want to know his inspirations musically and performance wise. Like I said, if I had to guess, I would say the Ushers, the Omarions, the Chris Browns, you know what I'm saying? Because that's the vibe that he gives off. He has that hip hop vibe to him. And yeah, I mean, I see he's got a Smooth Criminal by Michael Jackson performance video. You know what I'm saying? He's got more covers. I got to see more because I'm genuinely impressed with him. You know what I'm saying? I was before, but now I'm locked in. That was amazing. He ate that and man, super talented. So before you all go, make sure you all like, comment, subscribe, turn your post notifications on. Got a lot of stuff coming your way. And yeah, till next time.